some point. So again, I don't know exactly what happened with that, but she was raised by Keith and Lonnie Henry, and 5 years after she was born, Keith and Lonnie had a little boy who they named Ryan. Nova was described as just being a beautiful girl, both inside and out. Those who knew Nova said she was just very kind. She never thought she was better than anyone else, and she made friends easily. And one of these friends was a boy named Eddie Curry. Now, Eddie was a very tall friend. He towered over Nova, but they really became like best friends in elementary school and junior high. So Eddie started playing basketball in 7th grade, and soon he became this basketball star. All through junior high and high school, Eddie and Nova remained really close friends. The two went to Thornwood High School in South Holland, Illinois. And by the time they were in their last years in high school, Eddie was this huge basketball star. And I mean huge as in he was very well known. He was like this hometown hero. But also, his senior year, he stood at 6'11", and he was like smashing all of these basketball records, making a name for himself. And Nova was part of the school's dance team. It wasn't until their senior year that the two of them decided to take their relationship to the next level, and they began dating. In the fall of 2001, Eddie was asked to be a part of this documentary that kind of followed different high school basketball stars. Like, these were the people here. In May of 2001, Nova and Eddie both graduated high school, and they were both very much in love with each other, but they wanted to go out and chase their dreams. Nova was headed to college. She wanted to go to college, dental school, and open her own dental practice. And Eddie signed a letter of intent to play college basketball, but then decided against going to college when he got an offer from the NBA. So he went straight to the NBA to play for the Chicago Bulls. Nova and Eddie continued dating, and they were 19 years old at this point, and Eddie is making a ton of money. He would fly Nova out to watch him play when he had away games. They were young, and this was very exciting. Eddie had been a high school basketball star, but being in the NBA was an entirely different level of fame, and women because Corey was pregnant with Eddie's first child.
She was so excited. She's pregnant.
this man who she thought loved her and cared about her. She's now dropped out of college to follow him around the world, and he's married someone else and is having a child with someone else. I guess Eddie did promise to take care of Nova and the child financially. In November of 2005, Nova gave birth to a little boy named Noah, and she was in heaven with her sweet little baby boy. And at first, Eddie was sticking to his promise to take care of Nova and Noah, but after his relationship, or his marriage to Patrice, the support began to kind of dwindle. So Nova got a lawyer named Frederick Goings, and she decided to take Eddie to court to get child support for Noah. The court did end up ruling that Eddie would have to pay Nova $6,000 a month for child support. Okay, so let's talk about Frederick Goings, the lawyer, because he is a sleazebag. He was 33 years old at the time he began representing Nova. She was 24. But he had several domestic violence charges against him dating back to 1997. Choked one of his girlfriends, and in court she said he had been physically abusive to her for years. He was charged with domestic battery, and reckless conduct in that situation. He got 2 years probation for it. In October of 2002, he was charged again for domestic battery, for punching a different girlfriend and dragging her into his apartment. A few months later, he beat up the same girlfriend and bit her nose. Again, he got charges for domestic violence, but this man was basically getting like a slap on the wrist every time. He was able to continue his law practice, continue seeing clients. So he's kind of this awful guy, but he's representing Nova, and the two begin to develop feelings for each other. And eventually Noah and Nova moved in with Frederick. And it wasn't long before he began abusing Nova. I guess at one point it was reported even Eddie tried to get her to leave her boyfriend, but Nova was terrified. She was scared that if she tried to leave, he would come after her or her son. In April of 2007, Frederick tried to push Nova down a flight of stairs. And this was her breaking point. She was done with him, and she did try to leave him. But he threatened her by saying that it was not in the interest of her to leave, and it was not in the interest of her child to leave. Nova got an order of protection against Frederick, and he ended up being charged with phone harassment and domestic battery against her. Now, I have no idea what happened between the time she got this order of protection and 11 days later, but something happened within those 11 days. And for whatever reason, she had the protective order terminated. She had moved out. She was living in a different apartment with Noah, obviously he is still married to Patrice, and he's this big basketball star, so people were always watching him, so they had to keep it very quiet. And soon, Nova was pregnant again with Eddie's child.
Son up and rushed him
Just live to kill Nova. And as soon as they started looking at him and they realized he was on the run, like they couldn't find him, they had pulled footage from Nova's townhouse immediately after finding the bodies. And among the vehicles in the area were a silver BMW and a black Range Rover. Both of these vehicles were traced to Frederick Goings. Neighbors told police that they had seen these vehicles parked in Nova's assigned parking spaces the day before the murders and the day of the murders. But when the bodies were discovered, the black Range Rover was missing, although the silver BMW was still parked out front. So police used Frederick's cell phone pings to try and locate him. And they found out he was, or his phone was, in Michigan City, Indiana. So he had left the state at 3:30 a.m. on January 25th, so the day after the bodies were discovered. Police located Frederick's Range Rover in a parking lot outside of a Comfort Inn in Michigan City. They searched the hotel room that he had checked into, but he was no longer there. They were able to secure a search warrant for the Range Rover, and inside they found the presence of gunshot residue on the steering wheel and the driver's side door handle. They also found one shell casing inside the car. At this point, they had a lot of evidence suggesting Frederick was involved. And Nova's mother also said that as she was taking Noah out of the townhouse on the day she found her daughter's body, she asked Noah, "Who hurt your mommy?" And he reportedly told her, "Frederick did." So police put out a bolo for Frederick Goings, but weeks went by and they couldn't track him down. But then police got a tip that he was staying with a family member, so police and SWAT went to the house. They surrounded this home and they were able to take Frederick into custody. He was charged with two counts of first-degree murder for the murders of Nova and Ava, and he pled not guilty. The prosecution, however, had a lot of evidence tying him to the crime, and it was all presented in court. And they also presented a theory of what they believe happened on the day of the murders. They said that Frederick had been visiting Nova. It is unclear if he was there trying to collect money or if it was like a romantic visitation, like if they had rekindled their romance. But either way, he was there visiting her, which was why there had been no forced entry, because she had let him in. They say at some point he actually got on her laptop, and he found this file regarding the $24,000 in legal fees he was trying to get from her. It was at this point that he found out she had hired another lawyer and was actively trying to fight his request for this amount of money. And upon hearing that she had hired another lawyer and was going to fight this bill, Frederick say he then took off his clothes, jumped into a nearby swimming pool to wash away the blood, and then fled the scene and the state. The jury deliberated for less than 4 hours before finding Frederick guilty on both charges. He was sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole. When the sentence was handed down, Frederick was allowed to speak in court, and he said, quote, "I maintain my innocence. I loved Nova and Ava, and am disappointed with the jury's decisions." Nova's other grandmother, her living grandmother, Lisa Newman, said of the verdict, quote, "We are very pleased with the verdict. We never doubted it could be anything other than guilty." Noah's mother tried to get custody of Noah after the murders, but custody was given to Eddie and Patrice, and the couple are still married today. Patrice starred on a TV show called Basketball Wives of LA, and there's one, like, very controversial scene of this show, involving Patrice, in which she talked about adopting Noah and how Noah was a product of Eddie's infidelities. And people really came at her for that because, first of all, Eddie was with Nova when they conceived. Patrice was kind of actually the other woman because they had been dating before he met Patrice. But also, like, his mother and sister were murdered, so it just seemed like the comment was in bad taste. However, it would come to light that Patrice didn't even know about Eddie and Nova's relationship, and she had no idea that he had fathered two children with her. He would later say, so Eddie Curry would later say of the situation, quote, "A lot of people don't know about Nova. I saw her on and off for quite a few years while I was with the Knicks. We had two kids together. On the day Nova was murdered, shot down in cold blood back home in Chicago, one of the many people who didn't know about her was my wife, Patrice. Patrice also didn't know about the children I'd had with Nova, my 10-month-old daughter Ava, and her 3-year-old brother Noah. I kept it all a secret, all of it, for years. So as I'm on the phone learning that my infant daughter and her mother had just been murdered, I was also coming to grips with the fact that my marriage of nearly 4 years would almost certainly be over." End quote. So, I think this shows a lot about all of the lies that kind of surrounded Nova and her children and her relationship. Nova's brother, Ryan Henry, is this famous tattoo artist, and he opened a shop in Chicago called 9Mac. He said that his sister, Nova, was his inspiration. In January of 2017, Ryan posted a picture on Instagram. Now, this was Frederick's birthday, I believe, was the day that he posted this. But it was a picture of Frederick's mugshot with a caption that read, quote, "Maybe your God forgives him. I don't. That's why there is no sun out today." And this is is the case of the murder of Nova Henry and Ava Curry. Such a sad case. It is always horrific when people die, but when a 10-month-old baby girl is shot down in cold blood, it is so heartbreaking. And honestly, this entire story, like Nova's history with Eddie Curry and